Hello everyone, today I present the solar panel wiring to one inverter and to the grid in a self-consumption installation. The first point is to see the characteristics of just one solar panel alone. One main characteristic is what we call the open circuit voltage, also called U open circuit. For example, you put a panel like this one, a big one around 400 watts, and you connect a voltmeter, and for example here you have 40 volts of voltage in open circuit. Now, another characteristic which is very important is to see the short circuit current, so the maximum current this panel can provide. So here, for example, we have 11 amps as a short circuit current, which corresponds to the maximum the system can provide. Now we will see the characteristic of this panel in terms of maximum power we can extract. Put a load on this panel, we measure the voltage at the output, about here 38 volts, and the current, here 10 amps. You know that the power generated is a voltage multiplied by the current. So here we have 38 volts, 10 amps, so a power of 380 watts. This corresponds mainly to the maximum power this panel can provide. Remember this figure. Now we'll see how to interconnect six panels together. One solution is to put all this panel in parallel, wire the panel in parallel, so to connect the positive outputs with together and the negative outputs together. In such configuration, we obtain an open circuit voltage of 40 volts. It doesn't change from one panel because here they are in parallel. And for the short circuit, we obtain 6 times 11 amps. 66 amps, because all the panels are in parallel, so we have to add the currents. So the maximum power possible for this configuration is about 6 times by 380 watts, so 2280 watts. This is a configuration we will not use. Why? Because simply the current is too high. When you look at the total current, 60 amps, that needs very important, very large wiring, important cable, so it's not a very suitable configuration. Another way to interconnect, for example, six panels is to use six independent inverter, DC to alternating current inverter, totally independent, and we just interconnect them on the AC side. This will describe in another video. It's an interesting configuration also to interconnect panels, in particular in the case when you have one panel which is masked by a building or by a tree during the day. The solar curvature is not homogeneous on all the system, so it's better to extract individually all the energies from the different six panels. Another way to connect all the six panels is to wire them in serial. So we connect the minus of one panel to the positive point of the other, and so on. So all are in serial, and we attack the DC to AC converter. In open circuits, we'll have 6 times 40 volts, because in that case, you add the different voltage of these six panels. So we obtain 240 volts. In short circuits, we have 11 amps, the current of one panel, because they are all in serials. For the maximum power, we have, as before, 6 times 380 watts, so 2280 watts. This is an interesting configuration we will detail now. The only drawback is also when you have one panel which is not well covered by the sun compared to the other. It can impact in terms of function of all the system, because it will reduce the total current available. Most of the time, those panels are connected using what we call MC4 connectors. When we have these six panels, before connecting them to the DC to AC converter or the inverter, we need to put a switch. You can understand, simply for security reason, we have to be able to switch off the access to the DC part during the installation and so on. So we have a switch here, but the standard also requires that we put this lightning protection is dedicated to DC current. Then how works an inverter? So the inverter receives a DC current on the left. So we need an inverter here with a maximum power, for example, of 2.5 kilowatt here we have, because we have seen we have about 2.3 kilowatt at the input. So the inverter is able to manage 2.5 kilowatts. That's good enough. Maximum voltage 500 volts. We see that we will have maximum of 240. So it's okay. Minimum voltage 50 volts. You have to know that the inverter requires a minimum of voltage to work properly. 50 volts when you have six panels in serial is then the configuration where you have very low sun or low light outside. And the maximum here, the maximum current is 30 amps. So 30 amps, we have a maximum of 11 amps with our panels. So it's 30 amps is okay. So this inverter is suitable for our configuration. You know that the power is a power of a system is a voltage multiplied by the current. And so we will see now how the conversion is done. If we go back, for example, to a situation where we have a short circuit, so no voltage at the output of the system, one panel or the global six system, we have seen we have about 11 amps. In reverse, if we are working in open circuit, we have no current extract from the set of six panels. So we have 40 volts multiplied by six, so 240 volts. In both cases, we have no power product because either there is no voltage or here there is no current. But somewhere in the middle, there is an optimal for this product where the power is maximum. Here, our situation is roughly with a current of 10 amps and a voltage of 38 volts per panel, so in total 228 volts. It's this point which is very important, where we have, if we have a lot of sun, the maximum of power. Obviously, if the sun reduced, the level of sun reduced, this figure will move on the left. So the purpose of this solar inverter is to track this point, to be all the time in a situation where we extract the maximum of power of the group of panels. It's what we call the maximum power point tracking. We track this point. There is another way to present it. This point is here we have power. The power scale, here we have the voltage scale, and with low voltage we have no power, we just increase the voltage at the output of the group and we arrive to a maximum here, the maximum of power, and if the voltage go over 38 volts up to 40 volts per panel, with this total power will reduce. This is another way to represent where is this famous point. There's a maximum of power, so I repeat, it's the purpose of the inverter to track this point. There is a second activity for the inverter, is to perfectly synchronize the output signals, the alternative current signals, to exist to the existing current received from the grid. As a system at 50 Hertz, for example, in Europe, 60 Hertz in the US, in Europe, so a period of 20 milliseconds. The signal generated by this inverter must be perfectly synchronized in frequency and phase with the frequency of the grid, because in a self-consumption installation, when we consume a lot of power, part of the power can come from the solar panels, and the remaining power we need comes from the grid, from the outside. So those two signals or two generators must be perfectly synchronized in frequency and phase. This is the second activity of the solar inverter, to find the frequency and the phase of the grid and to synchronize on it. At the output, on the air output of the inverter, we have to put also a circuit breaker, a differential one, as we have in every house, a circuit breaker, also 20 amps, and a lightning protection on the AC side. And you can see here the picture. This is so the complete configuration. Here you have a practical construction here. We have an inverter, robot, okay. We have the protection of the DC side. DC arrived from here. This is a DC switches. This is DC enter in the inverter and then go to the AC switches and lightning protection. So you have three different boxes. Just locate not too far from your panels. Here's the total configuration, the panels, the DC protection, the inverter, the AC protection, and you have also to interconnect everything with a good earthing line in order to connect to the earth all the elements involved in the system. And you go to the electrical panel you have at home, where you can also, for example, the circuit breaker, because if all this part is far away from your electrical panel at home, you just extend the line, and here you put on your electrical panel an additional breaker, just for you to be in a position to easily switch on and off. Another interesting configuration is, for example, if you want to wire two times six panels. Two times six panels here, you can have all the six panels in serial, as we have already seen. And here another group of six panels. And you have inverter, which have the answer, a 2 MPP tracker, two maximum point tracker. So you can connect one to the group of six here, and another one to the group of six here. And for the rest, there is more or less no difference. So it's a way to interconnect two different group of panels. Another way you can think of interconnecting two groups of six panels, if you have, for example, six and six, six on the east side of your house, for example, six on the west side of your house, and you connect them in parallel. That seems very interesting, but it's a bit of a risky situation. Why it's a risky? If you have a lot of sun here, you will produce a lot of energy here with a high voltage. Here you have less sun, less voltage. The result is that all the current will go, instead of going to the tracker, to the inverter, it will go to this set of panels, and you have a risk of fire. Simply because we will have hot spot, because the energy received from the top group will be spent here in the bottom group. And so we have a risk of fire, so it's not a recommended situation. You can put one, two, at least three panels in parallel when they are in the, roughly in the same situation with the same solar, the same same sun converter, so you have less risk. To solve this issue, there is also a solution, which is to put diodes. Diodes, because if you put diodes, the energy produced by this group will go directly to the MPP, the inverter here, and not to this group, and reverse. The only drawback with such a configuration is that if the voltage of this one is lower than this one, more or less the tracker will track the characteristic of this group, and you are not in an optimal position to extract the maximum of energy of this group. But this reduce or suppress, okay, this suppress the risk of fire and so. If you want more information of this system, you can go on my website, HTTPS FOX180B.FR. F180B is my call sign, my amateur radio call sign, because it's my, also my, one of my hobbies. I have article dedicated to ham radios, but also article dedicated to home automation. So go into this section and you will find all details about the system I just described in this video. And you will also, for example, have a description, interesting description and video of a system which will measure the output and input of output or input of power at the entrance of your house. Because the risk you have if you have a lot of sun is to produce too much energy, and the excess of energy will go to the grid, to the outside world, and it's better in your case to detect this situation and try to consume internally this energy, for example, by injecting the energy inside your boiling water. And so, thank you again for watching me, thank you, and maybe next time in another video.